muscle tense up around the joint and it doesn't rotate properly. It doesn't have to stop altogether, but it doesn't rotate properly. That means it's hard.
A když jeden z těch kloubů se nezatočí správně, tak jde to těžko.
Yeah, your whole movement is affected.
Takže celý ten pohyb je vlastně tím omezený, nebo je tím ovlivněn je celý ten pohyb, když jenom jeden z těch kloubů se nerotuje správně.
So the whole basis of the Chu Shangtan system is learning how to
rotate joints. Ale jeden kloub to nedělá to, co má, tak se to celý zhroutí.
Ale to je stejné, jako když si někdo zlomí nohu, že jo? Tak prostě najednou začnete chodit jinak a máte bolesti celého těla, protože máte...
Can you describe the one-inch punch?
This is the one-inch punch, actually.
All the joints are moving at the same, at the moment of the contact, they are relaxed and moving.
I know that this is a favorite question. Most people ask, how do you do the one-inch punch? Actually, there's no such thing as the one-inch punch. You either generate the power or you don't generate the power.
Okay.
If you generate the power, the difference between the one-inch punch and a push is the time frame.
Can we translate it?
No, s tím, jak teďka to říkám, s těma asima úderama, že vlastně...
Že buď generujete sílu, nebo negenerujete.
Vlastně, že není nic jako one-inch punch, prostě buď to generujete správně, nebo to negenerujete podle těch pravidel.
So going back to what we were discussing before, if you can generate the power such that you use very little muscular effort and you take advantage of all the mass in your body and the mass on the planet, you generate quite a fair bit of power with very little effort. The next thing you do, talking about one-inch punches, the time frame you release that power. So using the big guy here, if I generate the power by release it in a long way, he will just go backwards. If I touch him again by releasing in a shorter way, he will just jump. You see the difference? That is the one-inch punch. So all it does is that it's a no-inch punch actually. You can do it at touching. But obviously, if you want to break bones, then you just leave a gap so that you get the extra acceleration into it. But acceleration is actually a minor bit of it. The main power comes from inside here.
Can I ask you, what is the
short way? So if I take this power, I release this power, but I take a long time to release this power.
Takže on mluví o délce toho, jako, že kolik se vezme času na to, aby ho jako odsunul. Když je to dlouhý, tak je to daleko, a když je to krátký, tak jako poskočí.
Now I release the power in a shorter time frame. Just...
Takže jako, že vypustí na krátký, když je to na krátký okamžik, tak ten člověk takhle jako poskočí. Yeah. To je jako na rychlost.
Užívá stejnou sílu, nebo to, jak dlouho to trvá, než ji vypustí.
Is there any mechanical explanation? What are you doing now? Like, can you explain?
Yeah, it's all the joint rotating.
All the joints rotate.
Yeah. When it rotates, you make use of your body mass as well as the mass of the planet, the Earth.
Takže když zarotuje ten kloub, tak vy použijete vlastně svalovou hmotu vašeho těla jakoby ze země, from the earth?
Ne, nejenom, že používáte vasu vlastního těla, ale používáte vasu celé planety.
To
je divný, to je gravitace. Tak jo. Když padá jabko, tak prostě zároveň je přitahovaný.
Jste schopni využít celé země.
A true path, there's no obstruction. All the way from here, into my shoulder, down, scapula. Spine, into the hip, down through the knee, down into the ankle, and then planet. So then now when I push him, instead of pushing him like that, I push into the planet. That's using the connection to the planet.
So you are using actually the planet as the last bone of your body.
Exactly. So as long as you arrange the bones in a certain way, and you don't let the muscle try and pull it in the opposite direction. Because if I use the muscle, what happens is that I'm trying to do this, and he's not going to stand still for me. So if I use muscle, you wriggle a bit. I find it very difficult to shift him actually because he's got quite a heavy body. And that's because it's stiff here. Because everything that he does immediately affects me because it's stiff. I stuck to a wall now, isn't it? So now if this wall goes into the floor, now I release into the floor.
Takže všechno, veškerou váhu teď uvolňuji, vyvolňuji sebe a všechno jde do nohou, do země a z té země potom
That's using the planet. If you want to use the body weight, you need a body mass rather. because weight goes straight down to the floor. What you want is your mass to go into him, not into the floor. Because if I take my weight in the floor, it doesn't affect him, isn't
it?
But if I transfer this mass here into him, so it's not doesn't work. If I take this mass, release the skeleton structure, all the joints from top here down, so that the mass now transfer into him. So you hear about mass transfer. Mass transfer is nothing more than releasing the joints. When you release the joints here, all the mass is here. Okay.
I have a question.